Well, love from love, hope from hope, peace from peace. Welcome to the crescendo climax of the prophets. I respect Morgue, and I will be taking my hat off during this Halloween special. But it's time to let that crescendo of lights just explode all around us. I am not an enemy of Morgue. As a matter of fact, I'm on his side. The total destruction of religion shall happen, and it shall be by the shattering of the power of the holy people, Daniel 12:7, coming in the latter days of Daniel 12. Morgue has excellent ideas. In many ways, he's correct about a whole lot of things. But only I can destroy religion, because I do so by the everlasting kingdom age covenant given for all people correctly. You see, as it was, people, Christians stole the book from the Hebrews, and then they erased whom it was addressed for. It was addressed correctly in the Bible in Jeremiah 31 for Israel and all mankind. And in the latter days, the Bible says that Israel would inherit all mankind, and that God would know every single one of his children from the least to the greatest of all mankind. That is exactly what the Bible says. And so in this hour, as Jeremiah 31 comes forth, it's time for judgment to fall on the house of God to destroy completely. For I am the latter day Daniel of Daniel 12:13. I am Elijah, and Morgue can never destroy religion. Only I alone, because I am just as much of a Hyperion as Morgue, because I have the flip side of it. And we both have the same objection to see narrow-minded, obsolete religion, as Hebrews 8 says. Because when the covenant comes for all people, truly, truly, the Bible says that all faith on earth is obsolete, including Hyperionism, Christianity, Islam, Buddhism, Hinduism, and all the religions. For it is written, in the latter days, the Lord God says, I shall tear down all kingdoms of man's imagination, not built solely upon the Lord's unconditional love. So in this hour of his love's greatest power, he says to all of his atheistic children, he says, I love you with all of my heart. And he says to all the Satanists, he says, I love you with all of my heart. And to all the warlocks, he says, I love you in spite of, and because I have in spite of love and loving through kind of love. The world has a false god, and that false god is named Jesus. And that false Jesus is actually, in my opinion, the absolute true God, but wrong slants. You see, because Israel stole the book, and then they declared we are Israel and all mankind, in effect is what they did, and the blessing is only for us. But people of God, it is time to recognize the blessing, and it's time to put on the war paint. It's time to put away the butter knives. And if you can handle and keep a hand on that, then it's time to move along with happy, happy Halloween. And this will be the happiest Halloween for many that want to get with the right program of the blessing of love for each and every person ever born. And so in this hour, here's what it is, people. Hebrews 8 declares that all faith is obsolete when you get that covenant of love being given like Moses. I am the alcoholic of the Word of God. I am Shiloh, Genesis 49:12, one whose eyes are red and dull of wine, one whose teeth are milky white, one who holds the scepter of all authority. The vision of Habakkuk was for the appointed time at the end, and surely the Lord said, it will not lie, though it tarry, wait for it. And the vision was written plainly on the tablet, so all those who hear it read may run. It's time for the greatest exodus on the planet Earth. Time for all wheat to leave the tares behind. If you don't take the bad fruit out from the good fruit, all the fruit go bad. Morgue official has no condemnation over him whatsoever from the Lord for the messages that he is preaching. If he lets his love light go out, then there is only condemnation over anyone when we become loveless. Christianity does not believe the Bible in many ways, and their faith is totally obsolete because all people have a false God, including no God. And the only true God is love. Unconditional, as the Bible says so in his covenant. He says, I will return my terrifying, fierce anger if my people will now just be loving towards other people and let kindness go in front of them. So in this hour of love's greatest power, we are all like the opticals here. And we're all like beautiful flowers, but together we're a beautiful botanical garden. And only that can set us free is the light of love. Love is the only thing in this world that will. Wide is the way unto hell, and it's paved by conditional love that's never been faithful, loyal, never been dedicated, never been merciful, loving, kind, patient, long-suffering. The God of this world has conditional love, and he does not exist because there has never been anything such as conditional love. And they have a false God because they got a respecter of man God. The Bible says that's a sin to have favoritism. And so they have adopted a Lord God who is not the good shepherd of all the flocks of man. That's how you know that he's not the true God. And they have not the true God who says, I am the Lord God of all mankind, Jeremiah 32:27. They are one, the Lord, the Messiah, and the Lord God. And there has never been condemnation, Jesus said, for anyone who becomes as a little child. For I tell you, unless we become as little children and have our love alive, then we have none at all. So our love must be a verb moving in motion. That is the blasphemy of sin. Jesus said, even sin against me, not believing in me, would be forgiven. Just not him living in us, which is the Holy Spirit. We're no damn good. Morgue, you're no damn good. I'm no damn good. None of you are any damn good. I am the alcoholic of Habakkuk 2. One transgressed by wine, and the just will live by my faith, even though my soul might not damn well be correct or right in ways. I like my hash, and I like my weed, and I smoke a little bit of it here and there. But you know what? I got my war paint on because it's time to put away the butter knives. It's time to have something sharp that can slice a man's soul right out of his spirit. So I hereby challenge Morgue official to a good debate. I've been calling out his name for 2 years now. He can only ignore me because he's chicken shit. He can swallow a sword, but he knows he would lose the debate with me. Because as it is written in the latter days, Satan has been removed. Diablo, Beelzebub, Mephistopheles, the snake of Eden, Lucifer, whatever the damn you want to call that old devil. According to the word of God, and this is what will cause the shattering of the power of the holy people, God's way must be prepared, Malachi 3:1. And what prepares his way is the words, I am your God, you are my people, I forgive all your iniquity. And God would be a liar if he was to be real. And you can believe anything damn well you want. Salvation's never depended nothing on us except keeping him in us alive, our love, because he is what makes us good. And if love as a child is living in any of us, then we're pretty darn good most of the time, even when we're sleeping. So if you look here, this says Hog Heaven. And Hog Heaven is exactly what it says. Hog Heaven has been for hogs, and the heaven is paradise of love. And the Lord says, there shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth only for those committing blasphemy, leaving the land of the living, standing in the land of the walking dead, having a form of godliness, but denying the power of love. Everybody in this world is becoming a road rage people, because what's happening is their love is waxing cold. Wide is the way to hell, paved with conditional love, people. And that's because we rationalize and justify each and every day why it's permissible not to love, why it's permissible not to forgive others and be merciful and kind and patient and forgive people in spite of their errors, because we've all made many. There is no good man, not even one. And the Bible says that in the latter days, all faith would be obsolete when you hear that covenant given by the alcoholic, one like Moses, who has eyes red and dull of white, one where it's written plainly on the tablets. Because the bottom line is, I am as hell, and I can never be satisfied as I embrace all people to the true God, who is a Lord God of unconditional love, as His word says. He says, I am your God, you are my people. And Satan has been sent for 1,000 years, according to Daniel 12:1, because he's always been, according to Scripture, the accuser of the brethren in the book of Job, and day and night before the Lord accusing us. So you know what, people? It is time to put on a hat and cock it like someone cocky. And you know what? If we're willing to do that, we can wear a lot of hats in this world. But I always will take my hat off to Mr. Morgue, because he is a trailblazer. And the light that he has been shining in the darkness in many ways is a bright light. He is off on some very important issues. However, it does not make a hill's bean a difference if people will keep their love alive. So if you do not have your love as a verb, truly unconditional, because if we're puppet masters with our love, then we deceive ourselves, thinking we have people we love, when it's all conditional. If they don't do exactly what we like, we only have, most of us, just if or and or but kind of love, or because kind of love. And as soon as you don't fit into their parameters, off goes the light. But hogging heaven, people do not and never have got saved, and Adam and Eve had no belly button. The truest truth for people to appreciate the rainbow of love that is coming, the truest truth is that people got to listen to the word of God. Because if people will, they'll be listening to one from Canada. And what I hold is something that a morgue official does not hold. I got shit pie, and that's just fake shit. But the fake shit, it serves a purpose, and the fake shit is for one reason, people. The Lord God says, if my people, my religious Pharisees, if they will not embrace that which glorifies my kingdom of love and peace, I will take the diarrhea, shit, dung, crap, pie from Malachi 2, and I will smear it in their faces, and they'll be drinking diarrhea, shit, right down their throat, coming out their ears. I want to see Christianity destroyed as much as all of you, because I was a religious bigot and a spiritual apostate myself most of my life, until I finally had open-eyed dreams and visions and heard the audible voice of God. And He gave me a miracle of writing by a lamp for 7 minutes, never plugged in. And so the Lord has been dealing with me abundantly for a long time. And it's time to put on a third eye, if you believe in that, and go be like a miner. Go searching for emeralds and rubies and sapphires. Come with me unto the sapphire sea, where there is the forgiveness of forgetfulness there, the crystalline, bluest, bottomless ocean of His love. Christians cannot even receive that because they don't believe the Bible. Against the Bible, they do not believe that other people are saved at all. And they have their God of favoritism. So you know He's a false God. So to backtrack that, God of favoritism, wrong. God not of all mankind, wrong. God of conditional love, wrong. Stupidness. And so in this hour, we need to get our definitions right. All those who love are born of God and know Him, because God is love. So if you are an atheist, or you are an atheist, were smart. They did not believe the crappy, wrathful, angry God exists, and He never has, praise the Lord. There has been a mystery, and that's been part of His mystery, His love. We've only been seeing a little by little, part by part, and we have not understood much. So the Bible says we have nothing but desolate heritages, Isaiah 49:8, and it's my job to reassign that. Unless the hearts of the fathers turn to children, children to their fathers, this world will be utterly destroyed. No birds, no fish, no mankind, Zephaniah 1, the earth in pieces, never to rise again, Isaiah 24. Moses said utter death in front of his end time counterpart, giver of the law of love, the new Exodus leader. The wheat and the tares can't grow together any longer. So it's time to become a flame of fire. And if you are willing to, and if you are willing to get in someone's face, in a nice way, be kind, don't road rage on people. I've been good about that. It came to pass a week or so ago, what I did, I saw my dad one time put a shotgun to a man's, to his stomach, and he's holding it there, and my dad leaned over and he put his nose like an inch away from, and you mother friggin', you son of a, you don't have no friggin', and you can't do little, damn, exclamation mark, and yelling. And so I didn't yell. 2 weeks ago, I walked to a Parkwood Gospel Temple in Windsor, Ontario. One day I had a walk in there and I yelled, fuck, 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 at the top of my lungs because the pastor was dodging me, give me no time of day. See, no Christians believed in the word of God, and the whole world is apostate with religion. Most of them don't even have no foggiest clue of what the Bible actually says. But the truest truth is it's time to tear down the walls, time to pull down the valleys, time to lift up the mountains. Say to that flood of his love to stop in the valley, he will not obey you. That flood of his devotion, his beneficence, his magnificence, his charity, and his total beneficence of his splendor goes before him. That is his love. And he's making a way for us where it has seemed to be no way. But it is through the shattering of the power of the holy people so that the wise might shine as the sun. So get ready for the very best Halloween special you have ever heard. And be as a flame of fire. And be like a gangster. A gangster of love. Tilt that hat a little bit. And if you're willing to do that, we're going to have an awfully good day. But, you know, the truest truth here is that Mr. Morgue, he really wrongly thinks that I'm some kind of bozo. And you know what? If I got to be a bozo for the Lord, who does exist, he is love. Listen, people, of things to come concerning the future of my sons and daughters and the work of my hands, command ye me. I did. I wanted the fleece wet, the ground dry. I wanted a miracle. And I said, I'm not even going to believe you unless I have something. And he turned on a light bulb for 7 minutes, never was plugged in. And that's the candlestick of Zechariah 4. I am the alcoholic of Zechariah 3, standing there before the Lord with barf all over himself. My beginnings was sniffing glue. I almost died, passed out with a bag of glue glued to my face. I had a frig the world attitude. Damn, I don't give a damn. And I had the worst attitude, and I've been alcoholic all my life. Although I just quit drinking about 2 months ago, I'm proud of myself. I'm doing actually very good. My doctor said, hey, your triglycerides are off the map. So it's like, well, if I don't listen to my doctor, what's the point of having one? And I want to live because I've got an important message to give, because it's my job to turn the hearts of the fathers to the children, children to the fathers. And that will I do. And so love from love, hope from hope, and peace from our Prince of Peace. And know this, beyond a shadow of a doubt, Morgue will never accept a debate with me, because he's totally chicken shit when it comes to me. He's shaking in his, because nobody has any root or branch left to hold onto because of the prophecy that I had. I am the father of Chrislam, and Chrislam is all mankind. And the truth is, once we realize that the Lord God, his love is unconditional, the Lord God says, and no one will ever need to even be taught of me, for all people of love shall know me. All people whose love is as a child moving forth unconditionally for somebody or something. And if people have let their love wax cold, it's time to flame back on. Don't be a bozo no more. you know, you're either going to fall on the rock or that rock's going to fall right on you and you'll get a diarrhea shit dung crap pie in your eye. Don't do it. Fall on the rock. Don't let the rock fall on you. So in this hour of love's power, I'm going to do one last thing before I go. And I wish you all the very best day and many blessings. And like I say, love from love. Hope from hope. Where's my glasses? I don't know why I'm asking you guys. You're not here. I'm here. It's probably on the floor or probably on my head. Oh, dears. And you know, people, if you are parents and you're not supporting this channel, you are daft for one good reason. Oh, I gotta turn my camera down. For one good reason. The only hope for our children is me. Unless I turn the hearts of children to their parents. I make children's videos as Bozo, as a pirate. Captain R, are you ready for that? Are you willing? Are you able to go out into the deep for the treasure of excellence? I got me an eye patch and the whole bit. And I teach the kids, don't love your parents with just a if or because kind of love. Only love that's in spite of, and only love that's loving through things. Only unconditional love is real. The other kind is just a veneer, shallow knockoff, a counterfeit of the real McCoy. There has never been conditional love in this world that has been divine whatsoever. So we got to beat our sword into the sickle to learn the ways of war no more, which means to change even our identities, and to change it for the good. And I will be right back in 1 minute. So get ready for something really good for the kids. And make sure you have all those kids come over and join the SpongeBob Club. And if you're willing to do that, so ask yourself, guys, are you ready? Are you willing to take a bite out of religion? Because if you are, it's time to pass this along. And if you do, it's going to be remarkable. So get ready. Here we come. Countdown. And please like and share. If you want Christianity destroyed, I'm your only answer. And that is guaranteed. So get ready. Get set. It's time for revelation of revelation. Come unto me, my pretty. Are you ready for the machine of lovelessness? Can you dig it? I hope so, because the light will never go out on that unless people start defending the truth of the world of the word of God that wants to tear down the gates of hell. Because guess what? At the gates of hell, we're standing, we're in prison, we think that we don't want to go there, but we're already living it. We're living in hell, and we are prisoners, trapped by the very own venom that mankind created to help protect us. It is destroying us. And so in this hour, it is time to realize that people like Morgue, that are too chicken shit to debate me, who are loveless and not worried about his reputation, rather instead of actually doing something about unifying all people of love, regardless what the hell they believe in, because nobody's no damn good. None of you are. He's already had all of you long time ago. The joke is on you, my little pretties. And so people like Morgue, if they will not grow up, they become loveless people, bold, cunning, audacious, unsociable and uncourteous, inhumane, lawless people. And that is what the morgue my brother of another mother is. He is the revealed lawless one who is not the Antichrist. I was mistaken when I first had revelation of Morgue, but he was foretold as surely as me. I was foretold in Isaiah 49:4 that everything would be done in vain. Vain vanity of vanity, saith the preacher. And Morgue, he is foretold as the lawless one. He really is. And, you know, he's got a lot of truth. I lift up your truth, Morgue. So why are you afraid to debate me? Because you know that you would lose. Morgue's been a subscriber of mine, understandably, since I attacked his channel and became a troll under his videos for a little bit. But one thing is for sure, it's time to realize what in the heck is really going out there. By the way, the false prophet of the world is Dr. David Our, O-W-O-U-R, of Repent and Prepare the Way, to YouTube. He is the guy from Revelation 13 calling down fire from heaven. But it's not. It's just magic. It's a counterfeit. But he's claiming he's Elijah when I have the restoration of all things. I have given the Kingdom Age Covenant 12,000 times. I got 12,000 videos. And I am as hell. Can never be satisfied. So Morgue and all people turning towards loveless ways, condemning people, condemning others, all the condemnation stuff. Because if God condemned us because of our sin, then he would be a liar. And I don't need Satan around to tell me that. The truth is, he says, I am your God. You are my people. I forgive your iniquity. I will never remember, as long as it's not the blasphemy of the Holy Spirit, to kick love right out of your heart. It's never been about nothing that we do, lest any man boast. It's always been about the Lamb slain before the foundation of the age, foundation of the world. If you don't want to believe that, fine. Just keep your love on. You're all right. And even if you go two steps forward, one step back, you're still going in the right way towards the excellence of treasure, the priceless pearl, a great reward. So it's time to stop being like ill-tempered, unrestrainable, worthless people, deaf to advice, foolish, full of evil, unloving acts, unteachable, unjust, unfair, people that have no participation with others who are any damn good, because we're no damn good. And one unloving people becomes people that cannot be trusted in their agreements, people of whom there is within no peace. They turn out covetous and faithless unto love because they're disorderly with their twisted yellow journalism and spiritual bigotry and their racism. I don't care if you're a atheist bigot and you condemning all the other people, or if you're a religious Christian Pharisee condemning everybody. Condemnation is condemnation. In the Kingdom Age, they will walk with their God, and they will walk with their God in peace, saith the Lord God. It's time to do the best thing, and that is to beat the sword into the sickle, to learn the ways of war no more, to change our love and make it real into unconditional. So be not unfriendly and lawless anymore, Morgue official. Be not sedacious and faithless, uninitiated. Don't do it. Don't be impious and unholy all the time. Strive for perfection, even though it's not attainable. That's what makes us perfect. And so be not a person of lovelessness, because they become unsettled, unstable, and abrupt and brutal and slavish and cowardly, intemperate. And if Morgue Fizzle don't debate me, you know he is all these things, because he don't give a hoot. He don't pollute. He say, I don't know. But all I know is that it's time to rewind all truth and enter not into the machine of hatefulness. For it is utter truth that if you let your love wax cold by your conditional love. You're turning off your love each and every day, rationalizing, justifying every day, defending why you're not a loving person. And you think that you've got love, but everyone has conditional love. And there is very little unconditional. Narrow is the way unto heaven as a child. So be not disgraceful and shameful with your unloving ways no more, doing and suffering in all infamy, like Morgue, colorless, immoderate, insolent, conceited, self-will, mean, envious, quarrelsome, slanderous, greedy, just the way Lucifer liked it before his kingdom age removal of Daniel 12:1. For I am the latter day Daniel. I really am of Daniel 12:13, who would arise to embrace his destiny as the giver of the kingdom age covenant message of Malachi 3:1 that prepares the King of Kings way, the roaring lion of Zion. And he's calling out to every atheist saying, I love you and you are saved. Just keep your love alive. That is me living in your heart. And the Lord, that's all the religion we need. And so it's time to stop being destructive and murderous unto love, becoming dishonest, cheating, deceitful, disobedient, obstinate, tricky, swindling, insincere, suspicious, hated, absurd, difficult to detect, difficult to avoid. And it is time to realize more than ever that truth of truth. And if we won't get with that program, we're gonna be really bad. And I am the messenger from the north. I will be right back. Ah, ha, 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 ha.